Thank you, panelists. Now, please turn your attention to the screens for a short video from United States Senator Tammy Baldwin.
Hello, Senator Tammy Baldwin here. I am so happy to join all of the elected officials, advocates, and community leaders here today for the 39th LGBTQ Plus Leaders Conference. Every year, I am so touched that the Victory Institute honors an up-and-coming LGBTQ Plus elected official with the Tammy Baldwin Breakthrough Award. This award recognizes their public service and dedication in moving our march for equality and justice forward. First, I'd like to take a moment to congratulate every person who was nominated for this year's award. All of you stepped up to the plate to serve your communities and move our fight for equality forward. And that commitment does not go unnoticed. So thank you. From city councils to state legislatures to the federal government, our governing bodies work best when they reflect the people they serve. They work best when people from diverse backgrounds and lived experience have a seat at the table. And that, of course, includes members of the LGBTQ plus community. When we have people of different religions, races, sexual orientations, and gender identities at the decision-making table, we are destined to make more inclusive and thoughtful decisions. We are also destined to set an example for young people, showing that they, too, can live their true selves and pursue any profession they want, including running for elective office. As you may have heard me say before, if you aren't in the room, the conversation is about you. If you are in the room, the conversation is with you. And this year's award recipient has fought hard to have a seat at the table and has made sure the conversation is with her. During her time as a public defender, she consistently advocated to help New York City's most vulnerable communities. As a New York City Council member, she has continued that fight by protecting a woman's right to abortion care, expanding access to childcare for all community members, and delivering support to survivors of gender-based violence. I am excited to present the 2023 Tammy Baldwin Breakthrough Award to Tiffany Cabán. Tiffany, the work you do on behalf of some of the most vulnerable in your community and further our fight for true equality, it's an inspiration. Congratulations on this well-deserved honor, and I can't wait to see what you'll do next. And thank you to the Victory Institute for all that you do to support LGBTQ plus candidates. I am so proud to be your partner. Thank you, and have a great conference.
Thank you, Senator Baldwin. Now, please welcome former Florida State Representative Carlos Guillermo Smith to the stage for the presentation of the Tammy Baldwin Breakthrough Award. Baby bet, ay, couple X, ay, couple Grammys on
him, couple Plex, ay, that's a bet, ay, throw it bet, ay. Good morning.
Good morning.
This award is fancy. Since 2017, Victory Institute has given the Tammy Baldwin Breakthrough Award to an out official who has punched above their weight when it comes to advancing equality through representation and through public service. I'm former State Representative Carlos Guillermo Smith. Thank you for that. And I'm honored to have been the first recipient of the Tammy Baldwin Breakthrough Award for my advocacy in the Sunshine State. And yes, I know we still have a lot of work to do. But I'm even more honored with each successive leader and award recipient that Victory has added through the years. It is my great privilege to welcome to the stage New York City Council member and the winner of the 2023 Tammy Baldwin Breakthrough Award, Tiffany Cabán.
I'm her, 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 her. She. Take a peek, it's me, 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 me. Take your friends, this her, 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 her.
You do you and whatever that is, I'ma do it better. Must have just seen me in it playing catch up. It's looking like Lil Megan's playing dress up. Would I ever spend a block on this? Never. I don't even wear an outfit twice. Dead dumb. Any bitch got a problem, probably never met them. Tell her, hey, the kids both cheeks child Bella. But I'm used to the chatter, cause I'm
her, 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 her.
I'm short. What's good, y'all? There's always nothing more joyful than being in a room of queer, so I'm happy to be here, and thank you. I always find bios, when they give them, a little bit uncomfortable. I'm like, this is what I really want you to know about me. I am a queer, Boricua, poly, Queens kid who grew up and still, deals with mental health challenges, grew up through generational poverty and economic insecurity, exposure to violence, to substance use disorder, became a public defender because what brings you to trauma work is usually your own trauma, and is just somebody who lives still and wakes up every day trying to have healing reparative experiences and help build through community, through changing dominant institution, through relationships, to build out life-affirming infrastructure that does just that, that allows us to heal and experience joy. And I'm somebody who loves my people, somebody who loves my dogs, loves books. And those are the things that I want you to know about me. I want you to know me, and I desperately want to know you. And I think that that makes for better leaders in our community as well. So I just want to say thank you for having me. It's an incredible honor to receive this award in the name of none other than the singular Senator Tammy Baldwin. And I'm far from the first to describe the senator as a trailblazer. After all, she was the first openly queer woman elected to the House in 1999, and the first elected to the Senate in 2013. However, being the first is only part of what makes Senator Baldwin a trailblazer. After all, the first queer person in a room of straight people might seek to lock the door behind themselves in order to hoard access and power. The first up a ladder can kick out the rungs that they've passed on the way up in order to command the most difference possible and maximize personal prestige. Or the first might seek to blend in, hide away, keep their head down, and avoid rocking the boat. And so in an attempt to cling to a tenuous step toward power, make it harder for others to follow. These are not the approaches of a trailblazer. To blaze a trail means to open up a pathway for others following behind. And that takes two qualities Tammy Baldwin has in heaps: vision and courage. Whether in her relentless efforts to break up monopolies and secure workers' rights, her years and years of championing Medicare for All, her early opposition to the war in Iraq, or dozens of other positions, time and again, Senator Baldwin has had the vision necessary to identify which is the right side of history and the courage necessary to stand there, head held high, even when it has meant opposing powerful businesses, influential corporate media, and even leaders in her own party. And that is the approach of a trailblazer. And queer liberation has always taken that kind of vision and courage. From the inception of the modern queer movement, with a riot in my hometown on Christopher Street in New York City, to the current moment, to the current moment of fighting for drag story hour, life-saving gender-affirming healthcare, and other vital struggles for queer safety and health, our every right secure, our every life saved, our every step toward freedom and equality has taken vision and courage. And this is a very scary time for queer Americans, especially those on the margins of our community: trans people, black and brown people, those in poverty, those with involvement in the criminal legal system, those involved in the sex trade, all of us are called to stand together in defending our beloved queer siblings in the face of grave threats posed by searing budget cuts to needed services, gross overinvestment in anti-queer systems of punishment and control, and an emboldened far right whose bigoted members go all the way up to the Speaker of the House. We need courage to face those challenges, but let us not forget that we also need vision to see beyond the challenges toward a new horizon of queer freedom and joy. Our vision for our family tree must not simply be that it survives bitter winds, lethal blights, cracked earth, and damaged soil. Rather, we must believe in growth, that our tree may gain more rings, that it might flourish and bloom for future generations. And that is the trail that Senator Baldwin has blazed for us, and that is the vision that must guide us as we walk the trail behind her. And so I just want to say thank you again for honoring me today. I just want to share that honor with all of y'all for existing, for standing in your power, for speaking truth to power, and for being in community each and every day. Thank you.
Congratulations, Councilmember Cabán.